Welcome to cutting tapers using the tailstock offset method. One of the more advanced procedures done on an engine lathe is cutting a taper. A taper is a uniform change in diameter at measured intervals along the length of a workpiece. Long, slight tapers can be cut on shafts placed between centers. In this video, you'll explore how to calculate, set up, and cut a taper using the tailstock offset method. When you know the taper per inch TPI measurement, you can calculate the offset by multiplying the TPI by the total length of the workpiece and then dividing that number by 2. If you know the taper per foot measurement TPF, you can calculate the offset by multiplying the TPF by the total length of the workpiece and then dividing by 24. If the workpiece has a short taper and the TPI isn't given, you can calculate the offset by multiplying the total length of the workpiece by the difference of the big diameter of the taper minus the small diameter, and then dividing that number by 2 times the taper's total length. For this example, our calculation for the offset is 4.65 multiplied by the difference of 0.45 minus 0.38 divided by 2 times 1.0. This makes our offset calculation 0.16275. Because the part's tolerance needs to be given to two places, we can round the offset amount to 0.16. Next, let's look at a Morse taper. This is a standard machine taper that's commonly used for holding cutting tools or tool holders. We've selected a number 3 Morse taper, which has these specifications. Remember, when the TPI measurement is known, this is the offset calculation. For this project, our offset calculation is 0.150 inches. Now, we need to offset the tailstock. High-pressure lubrication is needed in both ends of the part because the contact area between the center holes and the centers is very limited. This happens when the tailstock is offset. Begin by setting up the workpiece between centers. Leave the lathe dog fairly loose on the part. Use an indicator to make sure the headstock and the tailstock are aligned. Mount a dial indicator to measure the amount of tailstock offset. Set the compound slide, or rest, 60 degrees to the right. Unlock the tailstock using the tailstock clamp lever. Make sure the indicator is on the tailstock and not on the workpiece. Load the indicator about 2/100ths of an inch. Set the bezel to 0. Always move the tailstock toward the operator. External tapers that are cut from right to left always have the small end of the taper on the right end. Cutting this way allows you to control the depth of the cut. Use the tailstock adjustment screws to move the tailstock toward you to the calculated offset amount. Lock the tailstock. Watch for any movement on the indicator. If it moves, unclamp and readjust the tailstock. Check the tailstock offset using the indicator method. While this typically requires 2 indicators, you can use 1 if the lathe is equipped with a digital readout. Set the tip of one of the indicators at the center on the workpiece. Set the other to measure the amount of carriage travel. Reset both indicators to 0. Move the carriage 1 inch, or 10 turns of the indicator. Again, if the lathe is equipped with a digital readout, this indicator can be eliminated. The indicator on the center of the work should have traveled 0.025 inches. A number 3 Morse taper requires a taper of 0.0502 TPI. We move the carriage 1 inch. We need to divide the required taper per inch by 2. Because we're measuring the radius and not the diameter or the actual movement of the indicator. Some further adjustments to the tailstock may be needed to get the taper correct. Don't move the tailstock body once it's in place because it can change the taper setting. Next, we need to cut the taper. slide the lathe dog into the drive slot or against the drive pin. Tighten the lathe dog. Place the spindle in neutral. Slowly turn the spindle. The lathe dog will move in and out because the tailstock is offset. Make sure there is adequate clearance for the tail of the lathe dog. Move the tool into position for the first cut. Take a trial cut. Check the diameters of the taper at 1-inch intervals or by using a taper ring gauge. Adjust the tailstock offset if necessary. Long, slight tapers can be cut using the tailstock offset method. Power feed allows you to achieve good finishes. Remember, there's no special equipment needed to cut a taper using the tailstock offset method. You've completed cutting tapers using the tailstock offset method.